Welcome to World Star Hip Hop Wrestling, as I'm your commentator Thirsty Jack, and I got a special guest, Farouk. Tonight, we got three matches. We got Mark Henry vs. Al Snow, a triple threat match for the number one contendership for the World Star Hip Hop Television Championship, and tonight, the Hardcore Championship title will be defended tonight, with Dean Ambrose defending the title against Raven. Farouk, what do you think about this match? Man, I don't give a damn about that match. All that I know is my boys, Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown, is going to do what they need to do to finish the job tonight. All right, of course, I understand that OG Marvin had give you a title shot for the main event for the upcoming pay-per-view. World Star Hip Hop Present, Paid in Full, take place in New York City as you face in Dane Brown for the prestigious NWA World Heavyweight Championship. Give your thoughts about this title match. Is there any game plan for that? You know what, Thirsty Jack? It doesn't matter. Because you know why? Because I'm going to be the one who will beat down that little Billy Goat son of a bitch in the middle of the ring, capture the NWA Championship. And once I capture that belt, a lot of things is going to change the next night. Believe that. Farouk, what that was changing? What's that supposed to mean, Farouk? Don't worry, you're going to watch it. When time comes, I'm going to capture that belt by any means necessary. Well, Farouk, I wish you all the best of the luck. I wish you for the title match. But right now, we're going to focus on Al Snow. Everybody knows Al Snow is a former Hardcore Champion. Comes in the TNA, WWF, ECW. He's a lovable Hardcore legend as he goes up against one of your members from the Nation of Domination, Mark Henry. And right now, this match is going to be an epic match. It will be an uphill battle. Everybody knows Mark Henry is the world's strongest man. And not only that, Farouk, why you built the Nation Domination? What's your goal for your group? Championship, main events, the money? What's your thoughts? It's not about the money. It's all about power and taking over. Once we take over this World Star Hip Hop, we're going to make a change. A lot of things change in any means necessary, and this all things are matter. Trust me on that, Thirsty Jack. Trust me. All things matters, like what? Race, color? A black life matter. You know what I'm talking about. I'm so sick and tired of all these damn people winning the title. Why we never see a black champion, Thirsty Jack? Why? Tell me that. Well, to be honest, I really don't know either, Farouk. I'm trying to explain it my damn self. To be honest, skin tone don't mean a damn thing. Okay, it's all about talent. It's all about what you're doing in the ring and out of the ring. If you work hard, yes, you can become the champion. I know the social, you know, things kind of pretty shitty, but to be honest, there's a good talented wrestlers out there. Skin don't mean matter. Thirsty J, you lost your damn mind. Are you smoking that damn reefer? Just stop smoking that damn reed, Thirsty Jack. Stop it. You know, damn hair will. Black Lives Matter. It's time for a change. When I beat this son of a bitch Daniel Bryan, middle of the ring, and you know what, this Jack? I don't need this. You gonna see me in the ring next time on Worst of Hip Hop. I'm gonna prove a point, okay? You know what? I'm out. Alright, I'm out. This is the stupidest shit. I'm out. Well, fine then. Go on, Farouk. Oh, fake ass son of a bitch. Sorry. Right now, Al Snow is taking the control. And Mark Henry's in a little bit of trouble right now. Oh, bastard. Anyway, as you can tell, Farouk have his motive to face Daniel Bryan for the championship. And right now, Mark Henry is about to get up, throw some elbow shots into Al Snow and weaken him. And he go for the swing, bring him back, and give him a side slam. Just hurt Al Snow's body right now. I know he's in so much pain, and Al Snow try to get right up. And now that I have announced the upcoming match during the painful pay-per-view, the tag team title is up for grabs as well. It'll be a mystery opponent as a new duel. If you're not seeing the video, it will be up pretty soon. The tag team title have took place before the show even started. I will show you the video in a dark match. Also, the tag team title will be up for grabs. Also, we crown the new Worst of Hip Hop Women Champion as well. We will show that one soon later on a dark match as well. And them two titles will be defending at painful. And we're going to find out who is the number one contender for them two titles. And I can't wait for painful. And after painful, there will be an after party at a club in NYC. It's called Blue Haven. It's a strip club hosted by DJ Watermelon and a couple of well-known Instagram slash model slash strippers. As we got Big Booty Bunny. excuse me. Lemon Lime Tammy. And also Big Titty Manda. And yes, that's all the stripper name. And Mark Henry just slammed down to the mat. And oh, I thought it would be a three. So much Al Snow still got a little fight in him. And this match is pretty much a back and forth battle right now. And not only that, look like Mark Henry about to pick him up. And hopefully Al Snow will fight back. And look like it'll be a one slide fight. Swing over a rope. And Mark Henry, and what the hell Dylan Brown is doing? Dylan Brown is not supposed to touch Al Snow and look like it might be a handicap match. But with the help of Dylan Brown, Mark Henry is choking Al Snow out. And not only that, Mark Henry is about to finish him off as he stands there and wait for Al Snow to get up. And nope, reversed by Al Snow, giving him a jawbreaker. And swing him into a turnbuckle and give him a strong dropkick. And Al Snow is about to do something. Give a little punch to the top of the head. And a quick DT. And Al Snow is about to finish him off and he go for the pin. Okay, Mark Henry can do it. And nope, Mark Henry got up. So far this match is pretty back and forth. And not only that, the next match, a triple threat match for the contendership for the TV title. I have my guest, OG Marvin, who run Rush to Hip Hop, will explain the talent and the splash. Oh, the smash. I know all his rib is broken up like a shadow glass right now. And Mark Henry got up and slammed him again. And Mark Henry go for the pin. One, two, and no. Al Snow still got some fight in him. And like I was saying before, OG Marvin would explain all the matches will take place in the pay-per-view event, Pay in Full. And not only that, the roster and a title in the future for this company. So far, this company is very good. Everybody known for as the worst of hip hop website. But most importantly, now it's known for not only for website, but only for wrestling as well. As we get the best talented superstars from all over the globe and other promotional as well. And back to the action, Mark Henry got up, get a little elbow gut to the stomach, and Al Snow had let loose. And Al Snow had been distracted by D'Lo Brown. And Mark Henry going to sneak up on him. Turn around. And he going for like a suplex. Yep, a vertical suplex and bam, slamming into the ring. Throughout this whole match, Mark Henry had been dominated Al Snow. And Al Snow had been dominating Mark Henry. So this is a good back and forth battle between technique and strength. And for nation domination, only thing I can say is I wish them all the best of luck, and I hope Daniel Bryan kick Farouk ass for real with his militant ass. But anyway, Al Snow got him, quick jab to the stomach, and quick headbutt to the face, and Mark Henry got him, and he tossed him in the air like it ain't nothing. And Mark Henry about to finish him. Oh wait a minute, the world's strongest splash. And we are so good, we have to see it again in the replay. And he go forward. One, two, and no, he kicked out. Al Snow still got a little fight in him. And this is amazing. And all this time, I thought Al Snow will lose this match, but little Al Snow can come back and win it all. Can Al Snow make a comeback? We never know. But, oh, drop kick to the chest. And Mark Henry is on the ground. And Mark Henry kicks him away, and he fall down, and Mark Henry is setting him up. Is he prepared for the world's strongest slam? Got him up and bam, and this is it. Can Al Snow kick out? And that's it. And that's your match. Mark can win by the pinfall, along with the Royal's Strongest Slam. And that was a good match and good win for the Nation of Domination. And still, I'm trying to figure out what the hell Farouk was talking about. Talking about Black Lives Matter and big things gonna change. And I'm starting to worry about that because we don't know what that post means or what's about to happen. But all thing else is, we gotta wait and see for the pay-per-view. Painful is gonna be bananas. As we wait for the next match, OG Marvin will be up here very, very soon as he can get here, hopefully. And this Worcester Hip Hop sponsored by the new play by Henry Simmons from the 42 Baptist Church called Oh Lord, Who Stole My Mama Hot and Cheese Sandwich. Directed by, of course, Henry Simmons. Acting by Odd Man Johnson, Buff Bagwell, Sonny, Miss Jacqueline, and Tyler Perry. And that will be next month. And sponsored by Henry Simmons of his play called Oh Lord, Who Stole My Mama Ham and Cheese Sandwich. Alright, that's the most ghettoest damn sponsor ever owned by World Star Hip Hop. Alright, upcoming to the next match, we got a triple threat match, and it's for the World Star Hip Hop Television title shot. And whoever wins this match get a shot for the title against Dolph Ziggler and World Star Hip Hop Painful. And here come our guest, the owner of World Star Hip Hop Wrestling, OG Marvin. What's up, man?
Hey, what's up, Thirsty Jack? Long time no see.
Hey, man, you know I'm hustle and bustle, you know it is. So, explain how the World Star Hip Hop Wrestling was born. You know, can you take us back from the start?
Well, I got all the money from selling dope. Donation.
Donation.
And you know, we put all the money together. You know, me, Travis. And I never trust that bastard, Money Making Jordan. That guy right there, you know, we don't trust him. You know, he was young, he was slick. Like, can't trust that motherfucker. But we all come together. We put money together. And after that, you know, had a little fallout. So I took all the money and I put it in the Worst of Hip Hop. Of course, we, you know, put little money together and started the Worst of Hip Hop. Yes, we did a, you know, website that we all created, and now we become a wrestling. Not only that, all the wrestlers from Mexico, USA, Japan, free agent wrestlers. We got Prince Puma from Trooper A. We got, you know, Nublub from previous events. We got Jimmy Furry from other promotions. All people come here to put up a great wrestling show.
And I can tell you got great talent. I did some searching. I did find some talents as well. And not only that, and being responsible to find these great talented wrestlers, scouting, searching, researching, and bring these guys into the ring and pull up a great match. Also, Marvin, what are your thoughts about the championship pictures? Give me your thoughts about that one.
You know, the title pictures is looking very, very promising. The NWA World Heavyweight Championship, as a little OG, always watching, you know, Ric Flair defend his NWA title against Dusty Rhodes in a steel cage match. Always seen, you know, plenty close old school matches back in my day. But have that title come home to World Star Hip Hop, have Daniel Bryan, who put up a great fight in Elimination Chamber, defeating five former champions, and in one night, pretty impressive. But I also noticed that we gotta give talented a shot, like Farouk, that man who busts his ass in WWF but never earned the world title shot. Yeah, he got earned that bullshit title shot against Undertaker, King of the Ring, but ever since then, he never earned a title shot. But right here, the World Star Hip Hop, we give people what they want at their one title show. That's why I give my man Farouk a title. Also, not only that, he could bring his people wherever they want, because this match is going to be a one-on-one match, straight up, no bullshit. So, okay, yeah, you give an opportunity. What do you think about the World Star Hip Hop television title? What's your influence by that one? You know, originally supposed to be the World Star Hip Hop and a championship, but like, you know what, fuck it, let's call it a TV title. Plus, that belt is expensive. I spend that belt like 50 grand for that championship belt with the diamonds and the gold, all that good stuff. Same thing for the tag team title. Matter of fact, all the belt I paid for is out of my pocket. And not only that, the TV title, Dolph Ziggler, he deserved it. Now that we got the tag team champs, I will not reveal. You gotta watch that, you know, on next episode, should I say, the Dark Show and the Women Champion. Now, there's lots of plans, and we are working on a big event taking place in South Carolina. We can't tell you that. We can't tell you what's the big plan gonna be, but it's gonna be a very, very big plan, and people gonna love it and enjoy it. But right now, we focus on the very first big pay-per-view, Big Show, and NYC Paid in Full. And I can't wait to see that show. I think that match is gonna be amazing. I can't wait to call it build up. So far, we know all the time will be up for grab. We know legends, you know, gonna be in there. You know, tell about that legends. You know, I signed some legends, some OGs. I can't tell you who they are, but I will confirm that they will be the first one to take a crack at the crowning new World Star Hip Hop Tag Team titles at Pay in Full. So, whoa. That's a breaking news? Yep, I just announced it. The Legends, Tag Team Legends, will face the new champions at Pay in Full. Wow, that's going to be amazing. I can't wait to see who going to face the champions, like the Legends against the champions. I think it'll be an epic match. And speaking of epic match, so far, the Triple Threat match has been fast and furious. We've seen Prince Puma putting work, New Blood putting work, and Manic, who put in a lot of work. So all three of them is fighting for that match. And knowing this is a Triple Threat match, it's a no DQ match. You can do wherever you want, do anything. Only thing you can win by is pinfall and submission. And right now, Suicide got a baseball bat and he cracked New Blood across the back. And speaking of hardcore, what's your thought for the hardcore match between Raven and Dean Ambrose for the World Star Hip Hop, or should I say the World Hardcore Championship? I think that match is going to be violent. Raven, he's the ECW legend. You know, growing up, big fan of ECW. Dean Ambrose, a lunatic fringe. These two guys going to tear the house down. I could tell from the jump off, and these matches, I will be surprised we see a little bit of bloodshed, but it's going to be a straight up hardcore match. Keeping it gangster. Hey, true that. And right now, it looks like New Blood is by taking over Prince Puma, slamming his knee into the baseball bat, and Suicide looking outside, looking in. And he go for the swinging neck breaker. God damn. And New Blood, wait a minute, Suicide go for a move, take it to the middle corner, and he give his own back suplex. So Prince Puma is out, New Blood is out, and he go, what are you going for? He climbing the second turnbuckle, and go a senton splash into New Blood ribs. And oh, backbreaker by Prince Puma. And Prince Puma's go for a top turnbuckle. Now what he going to do? He miss. And what's New Blood going to do? This match is getting crazier by the moment. And nope. And he push him into a turnbuckle. Give a shot to the back. And he got countered with an elbow across the face. Now they had a little back and forth exchange. And New Blood get an upper chance. Kick to the stomach. And he go for a sunset flip. Go for the pin. One. Two. Nope. Suicide kicked out. And Prince Puma attacking him. And so far, I can't wait to see I can't wait to see Pain in Full look like a face breaker by Prince Puma. And yeah, so far the match got pretty good. You know, I'm glad, you know, I picked these guys to do what they need to do. And it looked like Prince Puma about to finish this son of a bitch off. And he could do something real stupid. And oh shit, it about to go down. Oh, a goddamn, a souffle, and oh, a splash, and Puma going for pin. And no, Suicide kicked out. So far, we've seen two moves hit on Suicide at the same time, and it looked like this match is getting good. And I will say this could be a match of the year for the World Star Hip Hop. And oh, bam, kicked to the side of the head, and Nubla got a chair, and he hit him on the lower back. And chair shot, and no, he rolled out of the chair, and Puma snatched the title away, and he gave him a hurricanrana. Can Suicide get into the match? And Prince Puma go over, and bam! Speeding dropkick to the face. And Suicide grabbed his leg, and now this match ain't getting, and damn, this pimp slapped the hell out of Nubla. And bam, a moonsault from the second rope. And he kicked out. So, well, this match is getting crazier and crazier, you know. And I wish I should have thought about this. I think about making a brand new title. I think about bringing like a cruiserweight title. Or something like that. You know, a cruiserweight or, you know, any kind of division. You know what? I couldn't agree more. I think, and Chesha back to the head. But, I couldn't agree more. I think they deserve more titles. But right now, to be honest, Marvin, I think the title right now is low. And they'll try to the back of the head. So, they'll try to finish him off. But back to what I was saying, I think the match looked good. I think the rosters look good. I think these titles is good enough as it is right now. You know what? From a friend to a commentary to my, you know, talent search, I believe, you know what? No more until we find a new partnership. You know what I'm saying? True. But right back to the match, and he gave him a new neck breaker into the chair, and Prince Puma gave him a neck breaker. So back to back neck breaker. Oh yes, back to back. You know what? Well, good time be alive. Did you just mention Drake? Future mixtape? Yeah, so what? It's a good ass mixtape. Yeah, true. Oh yeah, and also, did you tell us about the after party? Oh yeah. The after party, you know what it is, Blue Haven. Yeah, I'll tell you about it through the commentary. Oh, good. Also, speaking of that, we got a special pre-party show, painful, being hosted by Kendrick Lamar, goddamn Drake, Future, and a local artist named Hot Cheesecake, some fat ass little girl, you know, singing. But anyway, it could be a great party, and it's gonna be food and drinks, and also a car show as well. And oh, a flipping power driver! This match could be over. This match could be over right now. Prince Puma go for the pin. One and no, wait, two. And Nubla had to break up the pin. And Nubla is going, and he throw him outside the ring. Now it is a one-on-one match. And went Suicide. Now he got him an octopus submission. Is he going to tap out? And nope, give him a counter move. This match is off the chain. And I'm glad we both booked this match. Yep, me too. But wait a minute, he go for a special submission by Suicide. It's kind of like a modified. Oh, no. He go for the submission right there. And he still got him. And Prince Puma is breaking that up finally. And we must have a winner to face Dolph Ziggler for the World Star Hip Hop Television title at Painful. And yeah, so you know, we need a winner right now. Originally, Tyler Breeze supposed to face Dolph Ziggler, but them boys at NXT had to snatch him up. Oh, punk ass NXT. Ain't nothing but no damn glorified WWF superstar. Whoa, Marvin, you can't say that. You know, NXT doing a good job. Bullshit. Well, last time NXT put a good match, huh? When? Well, you know, my ass. Look, NXT is alright, but they ain't shit to us. World Star Hip Hop is a new breed of pro wrestlers. We don't got no superstars, we got wrestlers. Matter of fact, I call them World Star Hip Hop Fighters. That's what I call them. Hip Hop Fighters, and we got women. That's it. We ain't got no damn divas. Fuck them damn divas. Alright, now shots been fired right now all over the world. And right now, Prince Puma is getting the upper hand. Suicide try getting into the action. Nubla is counter. And this match is getting tense. Right? Oh, he got him a jumping neck breaker. Got Suicide from behind, and Puma looked tired. And he go for the pin.
and he broke up the pinfall. And the crowd is getting the hype in Mexico City. I'm glad we're doing international right now. The first episode or last week we did with in States. Now we're doing Mexico, and I got a feeling it's gonna be epic.
That's why we are taking over the pro wrestling. That's what we do right now. Mexico, New York, Washington DC, Miami, whatever. We taking over this pro wrestling.
And he go for a swinging DDT, and Nuba is going. Is he go for the pin? And no, Prince Puma get him, and he bounce back, slap off the jump kick. And Prince Puma, and he go for a turnbuckle. And what he gonna do? And nope, been breaking about suicide. This match getting tense. The crowd was into it. And Prince Puma, and he go for a German suplex. No, a Mafia suplex. And Nuba tried to break up the pinfall. He tried to break him up. He couldn't get it. And it's over. Prince Puma is a number one contender for the World Star Hip Hop Television title against Dolph Ziggler and Pay in Full. Marvin, what's your thought about this match?
I gotta give all these three guys a credit worth due. These three guys put in work, and you go ahead as all time put in work. That means Puma won hell of a performance in the ring. Prince Puma deserve it. He gonna face Dolph Ziggler. I think that match is gonna be a match of the night between these two guys for the World Star Hip Hop Television title. Now Nubla and Suicide, they did a one hell of a good job. And you know what? I'm making another announcement. Prince Puma, of course, he earned the title shot. But these three guys, what they did is amazing. So what I'm going to do right now is going to be not a one-on-one match, but a fatal four-way for the World Star Hip Hop Television title. Dolph Ziggler is going up against these guys, Nubla, Suicide, and Prince Puma for the World Star Hip Hop TV title.
Well, wow. You know what? I couldn't agree more. That match is going to be a jump off and a fatal four match for the TV title in a match. All right, the next one, we got main event coming up real soon for the World Hardcore Championship match. We got Raven and Dean Ambrose main event. We see you at the main event. We're going to take a little break. Until then, I'll holler back at you guys. See you at the main event. Deuces. Also, we're taking a break right now. Halftime-ish. All right, deuces.